Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 12.4.1. This is available to everyone that has an iPhone 5S or later and iPad Air and later can install this, as well as the iPod Touch 6th generation. It came in at 99.3 megabytes on my iPhone 10 and a little bit over 100 megabytes on my iPhone 8 Plus. Let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 16G102, and this particular build is really only there to address one major issue, and that has to do with the iOS 12.4 jailbreak. You can no longer jailbreak with this particular update, so I would suggest against that if you're going to, I would suggest against updating if you're going to want to jailbreak. Now, if you're on iOS 13 already, it's not easy to install this. You actually have to downgrade. So I have a separate video on how to do that. And if you want to do that, you'll have to actually use iTunes to downgrade. You can't just delete the beta profile if you're on one of the betas and expect the update to work. It doesn't work like that. So you will have to use iTunes. Now, as far as any of the information regarding this particular update, Apple just says a malicious application may be able to execute arbitrary code with system privileges. So basically a jailbreak. And it says a use after free issue was addressed with improved memory management. So there could be improved memory management as well, along with that code, but that's really all there is in this. This is a very small fix for the jailbreak and security. So they highly recommend you install this, but also I wanted to talk about battery life, performance, Geekbench, and iOS 13. So as you can see, performance is okay on the iPhone 8 Plus. Swiping is fast. The same is true on the iPhone 10. Landscape seems to work just fine. No issues there. And 3D touch that you know and love is still there, unlike the way it works on iOS 13. So it looks pretty good and it's working well. Now, aside from that, battery life, many people were saying battery life was good, and then others were saying it wasn't so good on iOS 12.4. Hopefully it's fixed on this particular device. I have 97% battery health, but I haven't been using it other than just today for a little bit while doing this video. I've been using iOS 13, to be honest. So hopefully it improves. Either way, it takes a few days and I'll do a follow-up to check up and see how it's going after a few days and maybe run a poll. If you want to see that, let me know in the comments below, but maybe run a poll about iOS 12.4.1. Now, as far as the Geekbench scores are concerned, I did run it on both of these devices, and on the right, you'll see the iPhone 8 Plus has 10,639 for multi-core, 4,234 for single core. On the left, we have the iPhone 10 with very similar scores. They are running the same processor, 4,269 for single core, 10,640 for multi-core. Now, if we take a look at the actual history on the 8 Plus, since I've run it before, it's actually gone down a little bit. I did run it a couple times before, and it seems like it went down slightly, but the actual performance doesn't feel any different. So it's probably fine to install, but just keep that in mind. Now, also, Apple released watchOS updates as well as macOS and Apple TV updates. And with that macOS update, I would definitely install it, as it has to do with fixing some speed issues when you're working with larger files. So keep that in mind also. Now, iOS 12.4.1 is probably the last version of iOS 12, unless there's a major security issue in the future that affects older devices. And I say that because iOS 13 devices should be getting an update soon, and the 5S, the 6, and the 6 Plus don't support iOS 13. So if you have an iOS 12 supported device but not 13, we probably won't see another version of iOS 12 unless there's security vulnerabilities. I would expect iOS 13, however, in the second week of September, second or third, and then we'll just have iOS 13 from here on out on all of our devices. And that one's looking pretty good. Of course, I have a bunch of videos about that as well, but I think 12.4.1 may be the very last unless we see a major security vulnerability for older devices. So that's really it with this particular beta. There's not much more to say. If you'd like me to do a follow-up, let me know in the comments below. But other than that, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.